Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm here to talk about use of awareness web application as a tool for balancing technical security concerns and human factors. This is a tool that is derived from my MSc project. So I'm going to be talking about my experiences and the lessons learned all through the journey. I'll define the problem, talk about the recommendations from existing theory, and then the proposed solution for my project. So apparently, we have so many people working remotely because of the pandemic. And then we also have increasing complexity in each application because people keep asking for new features every single day. They want to keep increasing the features and the functionalities. So you find that the applications are a bit complex each new day. And then we have teams that are working across different cities and different nations. So we have those spread network systems. All of these increase productivity, but they come with a price. They also increase the cybersecurity threats. Yeah. So the good news is many cybersecurity professionals have come up with technical controls, things like firewall, antiviruses, digital signatures, all those are to combat such risks. However, they're neglecting that very important thing. These are the people, because people are involved in this entire process. So when you neglect them, you're leaving very critical aspects behind, and then you're focusing on the technical controls. So these have to go hand in hand. If you leave one on the other hand, and then you focus on one, you're not going to get what you want. You will leave loopholes that can be exploited by criminals. So we looked at people. So what exactly really do these people form? You find that when you have a person who is naive and then they don't know about security controls, no matter how strong your technical controls are, they're going to really expose you. Because if you have a person who just write their password and then they leave it under their company computer, a hacker will just come in, get that thing, just with no effort, they'll access your network. So what they do, the damage they really do will depend on how good your security controls are, but already that person is into your network. So that means we need to focus on them. Yeah. So the critical question is here, how do we strengthen the human factors such that we balance them with the technical controls? The major thing everyone will tell you is awareness. It's very easy to say we're going to create awareness, so we come in and we tell people this is bad, this is good, and all that. It's not just a matter of doing that, because we've seen before, people really know what to do, but they just don't do it. So we also, from theory, we found that, you know, the non-compliant behavior, for some people, it's out of ignorance. For others, it's out of laziness, like they just don't want to go through the hassle of doing some of the things that they already know. But for many people, especially the end users, it's actually, they just don't know what to do. You'll find a person maybe like in a conference here, they find a flash there that has been left with malware. They'll just pick it because they want to transfer a file, plug into a computer and expose an entire network. Yes. They just do not know. They are ignorant about the fact that, you know what, these social engineers or the criminals will use anything to actually get into your network and mess it up. Then you also have come to realize that if you're going to have effective cybersecurity, it requires all employees to be on board. They must know what to do and they must comply to it. So that means you must have some security measures in place as an organization to ensure that you combat all the threats that are available. So you must come up with things like, based on what you have and the digital assets you have to secure, you must come up with some measures and tell these people, you know, this is what we do. We make sure our passwords are strong. We use biometrics here. We don't allow anyone to come in. All those things, you put them in place, maybe document them, but then also tell your employees about it. Now, the thing is, very many organizations will do well at the start. So someone comes in, it's induction, they will tell them, you know what, these are our rules, you're going to follow them. And because they are new staff, they will really be excited, they will agree, they will even sign a policy. I have understood. And then you go on, as you go on along the way, somehow maybe there is some form of laxity. But then also, you realize that this one is mostly a one-time effort. So they will do it at the start, an IT person tells you, this is it, and then that's the end of the game. They'll never create awareness again. But the challenge is the cyberspace changes every day. People have different means of attacking, new softwares will come up, so you cannot afford to do it as a one-time effort. It must be a continuous event. Maybe you could say periodically, maybe every after 3 months you're going to do this kind of awareness and stuff like that. But you cannot say from the time the person comes, I'll only inform them about cybersecurity and measures only this one time. So if you do that, you've really lost the battle, because tomorrow there'll be something else to do. Tomorrow there'll be another virus, malware that is in place that people really need to get to know about. Phishing emails, there'll be more tactics to just get people's credentials. So you need to always look at what is happening, look at how your organization is really made up in terms of infrastructure, and then inform your people what the threats are and how they can be able to guard against this. So the truth is, awareness alone also cannot ensure that, you know, you're safe, but it has some form of guarding against this. Now, this is what I can say, that no matter how much you make those people aware, as long as they don't have that attitude to guard against threats, they're not going to really help you. So they'll have the knowledge, because we've seen even IT people who know what exactly they need to do, but they're not doing it right. So that simply means, on top of awareness, you need to motivate people. I just hope that the motivation is not a cybersecurity attack itself. Because some people are just waiting for an attack to happen, and then that's when they will start being careful. But sometimes, at that moment, the damage is already done. So you need to do it even much earlier and ensure that it does not happen to you. You shouldn't leave any loopholes whatsoever. So we need to motivate people, both technical people and non-technical people. They need to be aware, and they understand that anyone can be attacked. Recently, this year, there was an attack on a water plant. Personally, it really surprised me, like, who can attack a water plant? It's really ridiculous. Yeah, you would think when people are looking for money, so they'll attack banks, financial institutions, but people are even attacking water plants. That's really rare. So that really should just tell us that anyone, any organization, small, big, whatever the line of business, they can actually be attacked. So we should all be on guard and watch for all these threats. So basically, for my project, I designed an application. It's called CISA, short for Cybersecurity Assessment and Awareness. It will allow employees to just come in and take an assessment of how good they are at compliance. Now, this assessment has the part for technical people and then the part for non-technical people. Of course, for non-technical people, you will measure things like, would they really click a phishing email? Would they take a flash that is just left abandoned and they don't know the source? How good are their passwords? Would they really share a password if they're off their desk and a colleague wants to help? Would they do that? So that's what we assess in such things. And then for technical people, we're assessing on how vigilant they are. If it's a software developer, are they going to prioritize designing a safe application over fast release? Because many times people are rushing to actually release this software and they don't care about the loopholes that it might really cause. So we're looking at all that. I must say also, many times when you talk about human factors, we are thinking of the end user. But then there are times whereby even us as technical people, we are not really very serious about this. I'll give an example, like I said earlier on, for the water plant attack. These people had TeamViewer on the system and they were no longer using it. 6 months ago, like, that's when they had stopped using it. But it was still on the computer, it was still installed. My question would be, why is it still installed when you're not using it? Moreover, something that allows someone to remotely log into the system. Then the attacker, it's alleged that the attacker used one of the former employee credentials. Why are they still active at that point? They've gone away from the organization. Why are they still active? So such things, a technical person is still supposed to see that this really might bring a threat to us, might expose us, so I need to do it immediately. You don't wait for someone maybe to have gone for like 3 months and then you remember, oh, I was supposed to deactivate this. So that's why the assessment is made for everyone. The awareness is made for everyone. It's not only non-technical people. Everybody must really be on guard. So now, the assessment, you go in and you just take, there are just 10 questions, but I think this can be customized for any company, regardless of what they do, and also based on their digital assets, they can really take some assessment on how people are really complying. So you go in and you will be able to feel those questions. It's just a true or false. Do you do this? Do you do that? Yeah. And then after that, you get a score. So this score is actually intended to motivate you to do better. Because we imagine people who just come in and they really want to just self-evaluate honestly, like, how good am I with this security? So when they come in and they take the evaluation, maybe they are given a score, let's say 50%, they actually know, I am lacking here. Probably I have to do better. So they encourage people to do it like periodically, such that they know. It could be then added to your performance appraisal, such that you know, this is how good I am. Tomorrow, maybe after 3 months, will you be a better person? Will you get a better score? So that is actually to motivate them to work better. That today, if I get a 50, tomorrow I should get maybe a 70. So it's a form of motivation. But then also, it allows management. Many times people will complain about top management not giving them support and all. If you have such proof of, like, these are people's assessments, they're struggling here, you can better come up with support mechanisms to help these people comply. Because people have different reasons why they can't comply. It could be that they are writing down a password because there are very many passwords that are used throughout the organization. They can't keep them in memory. So you want to come up with a mechanism to just help them, maybe say, we'll have one password all through. Yeah, things like that. If there is need for training, maybe you'll say, in this area, we have very many people who are struggling. We need to do it this way. So it also helps them. It's just proof that this is where people are struggling. This is where they are strong. So you are able to help them. So this same application will allow you to take an awareness. So an awareness is actually giving you things like the risk, how you can prevent it against the risk. And then also, if you don't really prevent it, what would happen, the consequences. So you're giving them that holistic view, such that people actually know this is what is at stake. Many times people think they will not be attacked, or they actually don't know the damage. For example, individuals might not know that if you leave your computer there and someone logs into it, it can damage a reputation of an organization. For example, if you have sensitive data, and someone gets it, sometimes even you can be out of business forever. So such things need to be told to people, such that they know, if I'm not vigilant enough, tomorrow I may not have a job, simply because this company can get out of business because of my ignorance and because of my errors that I'm making in regards to security. So that's how this is based. Of course, someone signs in for you to track who is actually taking the assessment and how you can help them. However, of course, that really came with price, because I don't know how sure people would be to themselves if they know they're signing in and maybe their boss will look at this. I don't know how true it would be, but always we can work through those ones. Maybe you could use IDs or something like that, and you just track the department of the person. Yeah, all those can be worked out in different organizations, but for now, people register with their names to keep track. So, why CISER? Why did we come up with a web application? I said earlier on, awareness should be a continuous thing. Now, if you're going to come up with maybe manuals for training people every single day, you cannot keep up. It's just not cost effective. But a web application, that content can always be updated anytime based on what is trending, based on what is new in the cyberspace. You can easily change that. So that's why a web app was really feasible for us. And then also it includes an assessment module, which I've talked about. People can evaluate themselves and they're motivated to work actually better. Also, for management, people complained when we took a survey for this particular project, people complained like, you know, top management can just never give us resources to support us in terms of cybersecurity. That's why many times we don't even want to do the awareness, we don't want to do different things in regard to cybersecurity, because they think it's a waste of resources. So very many times people want the event to first happen, like they want to first be attacked, then they allocate resources to search. But I think they need to be told, so with the assessments and all, they'll be in position to know that actually there is a need to help people comply. So this is a survey that was taken to just understand, after the application was designed, we took it on to small and medium enterprises, we are SMEs, and we just wanted to understand, is this really effective? Would this do the job? Like, would it help to bridge that gap between the technical controls and the human factors? And yes, we had people, it was quite a struggle because very few people want to volunteer in such things. We got only 14 volunteers, and they gave us really great feedback, as I'm going to share. They were from different countries, England, Greece, South Sudan, and Uganda. So we had 6 from Uganda, 6 from England, 1 from South Sudan, and 1 from Greece. Now, regarding the assessment, we had 86%, that is 12 out of 14 people scored above 50, meaning that they were able to comply with more than half of the questions that were put up. They were complying. Then, 2 people out of 14 scored below 50, meaning that they cannot even afford to comply to just half of those questions, which we asked. But then I must say that with the 12 people who scored above 50, only 1 reported full compliance. That means 1 person was doing everything right among those that were stated, because there were just 10 questions just to see how this person is really doing. So only 1 person reported full compliance. Now, I think there was a problem there. Much as this is scoring above 50, you can't leave a loophole. So if someone is not giving you full compliance, if there is still work to be done, yeah? Because criminals will attack you in any way possible. They'll look for that one loophole and they'll go through that. So we need to encourage people and motivate them to actually have full compliance. Then about assessment outcomes, we had 79% of the people say that they were actually motivated. They're motivated to do better. Like after taking that assessment and they saw their score, they're like, okay, we really need to improve and we need to incorporate these things in our daily routines. Then 14%, those were only 2 people, they say they were not motivated. So basically, they didn't see any value for incorporating those things. Maybe they thought they did not want to invest anything, anytime, because perhaps they cannot be attacked. Those are very tiny things. So they believe the probability of being attacked for such things is really low. So they are not motivated and they are not willing to make any changes. Then 1 person was compliant, as I've said earlier on. So they were compliant. There was really nothing for them to change. They were just stick. Then awareness outcomes, we had 11 people say that there was an impact made after they read through the awareness content. There was something that they didn't know. Yeah. So that's the impact we're talking about. Then 29%, those are 3 people, they claim they actually have the knowledge, but they're just not applying it. Like, I know everything that was in the awareness, but I just don't apply it for one reason or another. Probably laziness or, yeah, but they just claim we knew it, but we are not doing it. So what are the key lessons, take home for me? First of all, this application was effective compared to the feedback we got from people. It is effective in raising awareness for cybersecurity and motivating people to comply. Also, one thing I really learned from all this experience, knowing the guidelines will never mean that you're going to comply. People need to be motivated. I don't know, maybe they should be told about these threats and all that, but as a cybersecurity professional, please make sure that even people on your team, technical or non-technical, they need the motivation of like, hey people, we are not safe, we need to really do this as a team. Not one person, but as a team. Then top managers think they need to prioritize security. They also need to be told what exactly is at stake, because business is at stake, but somehow it's not visible, so that's why they're still sitting back and they're saying, no, we'll not give you the resources that you need. But they need to be told that actually they can't even run out of business. This is a serious matter. Perhaps that's where they will really allocate resources. And thank God, CISA as an application can actually help you make your case as you go to your top managers. Then, the struggles with compliance, they are the result of either laziness or ignorance. The good thing is, all these things can be dealt with. Yeah, if it's laziness, you can always work out a way. How do we make it easier for these people? If it's ignorance, awareness, CISA is here to help. So I believe all these things we can be able to combat all the threats that are brought about as a result of and not knowing what to do and maybe lessons. Yeah. Thank you for listening. That marks the end of my presentation. I don't know whether I can take questions or that wasn't part of the program. Yeah.
So, great presentation. Thank you very much. I have a question because some of the key approach, which is the small. So, when you use the left walls, they often bring this into
the news. Actually, we can't hear you.
Oh, sorry. When you read the left walls, you often see that users, regular users, are counted as part of the brand. They are counted as part of the problem. And my thing about your approach is that you're counted as part of the solution. How much of that do you think plays into the success that you saw in the slide that you set up for the SOC, with 80% getting over 50% of the success in the online awareness? Do you think that the approach there plays a part?
I honestly think yes, it does. Not 100%, but it will do, like, let's say 80%. Yeah.
So you mentioned there about motivation. Did you have any specific motivations that you had to get for employee?
Okay, so the motivation for me, basically, it's a score. That should, like, when you take an assessment, you get a score. So personally, I would really think it is that should motivate you as a person to do better. Every score you get, you should aim for a better score. Yes, please.
How do you tackle many organization for our attention?
Oh, I think at the end of the day, I think we need to just make our case clear. The truth is, cybersecurity is a big thing. But people do not know about it, so we need to actually tell our top managers, executives, that this is a subject that is very critical and they need to allocate resources. I think we need to, if it means pitching ideas and telling them what can go wrong, we need to, inform them. Yeah. Thank you so much.